Welcome back everyone, it's Randy. Today's video shows another stellar weekend of progress is in the books and things are still moving full speed ahead. As always, on a Monday afternoon video, there's lots to see, so let's get right into it. Here are today's key takeaways. At the north end, we can see on the east facing side that many of the materials have been moved into the structure on the second floor and that painting has begun on the first. In the northeast corner, the GigaPress bridge crane rails were installed and another large section of roof concrete was poured. We also see that the roof installation for the area between the casting machine and the rest of the main building has also begun. We can see that they are using the squared steel columns we saw in the area last week to build the wall that will join with the main building. The south end wall panel installation is looking good on all sides, and there are only two more large sections of concrete to pour on the roof before they start putting on the final coating. The west facing wall now has all wall panels in place. Heading back up north, the long ground floor area that was dug out and was having rebar placed has had what looks to be ground concrete poured. It was very overcast today, so lighting was definitely not the best. We'll get a closer look the next time out. Back inside the structure south of the GigaPress, rebar is placed all around both of the lines going through this area, and it's highly likely we'll see concrete being poured in the next day or so. The west side steel structures have joined and are filling in rapidly. You may have noticed the school buses from other Quad Squad members' videos over the weekend parked at the site being used as plant transplant buses to shuttle workers around. We get a glimpse of them heading to a designated spot to possibly await for workers to finish up their shifts, as it was a little after 4:30 p.m. when we saw them on the move. The northwestern corner has a majority of the footings filled with concrete, and the others continue to be poured as fast as they dig them out. The last remnants of the large pit were finished being dug out in the last video, and from the image you're seeing, I think they're about to dig another identical pit since the footprint and space where they did not dig footers matches the area of the pit on the left. The switch yard is taking shape quickly as more and more parts are assembled and put into place. They look to be digging a new trench that will follow the white line shown in the image. Could this most likely be for some of the main lines to get power to the factory from the switch yard? Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you're new here, please be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell if you want to be kept up to date with the latest content. If you enjoy it, please consider supporting the channel on Patreon via the links in the description or at the end of the video. Let's get to it, starting in about 10 seconds.